Hi guys, thanks for tuning in. In this video, I'm gonna review the Canon C70. I had the chance to test the camera in various different situations, so I figure out for you what the camera is good for and what is probably not good for and if it's the right fit for you. Coming up. Hi guys, my name is Paul, I'm a German filmmaker and this channel is all about filmmaking, gear reviews, but also DaVinci Resolve tutorials. So if that's something that you're interested in, consider subscribe, I would really appreciate that. So in my previous video, I compared the Canon C70 in very different situations against my RED KOMODO, which I'm recording on right now, and also Autofocus is running, so I'm interested how that kind of turns out. But anyway, I had the camera for a couple of weeks for testing, and yeah, I think the C70 is a great fit for most of the people, but I'm gonna explain why in the upcoming minutes now. So let's talk about first handling, and yeah, the Canon C70 is different than other cameras, not like that it's made for that you can rig it out and something like that. It's more like out of the box solution, so there's everything you need already built in, and it's more like a DSLR form factor, so it's maybe not the camera to impress clients with a big cinema camera or something like that, for they're gonna think it's like a photo camera, which can be good, can be bad, doesn't matter, but that's the form factor that you have to deal with. I personally really like that we have lots of buttons which we can customize and all that good stuff. So really great that Canon has implemented that. Also, we have 10 stops up of ND filters, and we can record on normal SD cards, no CFast cards or such a fancy thing. Be aware of that you're gonna need V90 cards if you wanna do high frame rates and all that stuff. I will link some down below for you. But anyway, handling of the camera is great. I really liked also that Canon has a mounting screw on the side for vertical video. One thing that I didn't like too much was that we have the bigger mounting hole in the middle, so on the bottom, and the normal mounting hole is, we have two of them on each side. And therefore you will need an adapter plate to mount it onto my Ronin S here. That was not possible because either way the camera was too heavy to the right or too heavy to the left. I managed to balance it on my glide cam because there I have a lot more space and all that stuff, but on the Ronin S it wasn't possible, so just keep that in mind. Another great thing about the C70 is audio. Here we have mini XLR, same as the Pocket. So I personally don't mind that we have to use an adapter cable to keep the form factor small. Personally, I liked it, and I rather have professional audio input than not having it or whatsoever, or bigger body for bigger connector. I really don't care. So therefore, I think it's great that we have that in here. And yeah, the sound quality you're gonna hear right now. Every morning when I wake up, I need a cup of coffee. And if you like this kind of content, please subscribe to my channel. So I think you can hear that the sound of the camera is really great. And yeah, it's really high quality. So you can use it for interviews, documentaries or whatsoever. So the built-in audio here in the camera is really great. Then also let's talk about battery. And I was really surprised what Canon squeezed out of this little BPA 30 battery that lets the camera run for about 2.5 hours. And you can also buy a bigger battery, so like the BPA 60, which will be a little bit more bulky on the back end because it's not like a straight end then, but then you get double of this. And yeah, I think this is really amazing. So I was really surprised of the battery life. And also when you turn the camera on, it's ready to go for you within like 2 or 3 seconds, which is really fast. So it really feels more like a DSLR style. One thing that I really like of the C70, which I think is not talked about too much, is that that's the first Canon cinema camera which has the RF mount, like the R5 and the R6 in a kind of DSLR. or hybrid area, and I really liked it because the RF mount is going to be the future, because also RED, the Komodo, has now the RF mount, and it's like, it's, I think it's becoming the industry standard, because all the cameras that were shipped with EF, like RED's and Blackmagic's, they were going to have now an RF mount. And the additional benefit is of the short flange distance of this sensor. You can nearly adapt any lens what you want to, like a PL mount or EF glass or whatsoever. So therefore you're really flexible, and you have this internal ND filters on the CU70. So I think really great that Canon went with the RF mount here. So now let's talk about autofocus. And as you would expect from Canon, the autofocus is great. It works really well in tracking and all that stuff. And it also, yeah, does it pretty well. I didn't see any difference either if you use native RF lens or if you use older EF glass with the adapter, or also like third party lenses like Tamron, Sigma. They all worked pretty great, and I didn't see that much of a difference there. Really reliable, and tracking works great. I had just one problem, because I think still that the Canon EOS R6 and R5 are a little bit better when it comes to autofocus, especially when we are talking about tracking, because when I turned my head around and the camera was only seeing the back of my head, it lost focus when I was moving closer backwards to the camera, whereas the R6 and R5 didn't do that, and also they have like animal autofocus and all that stuff. So little bit more better on the EOS R5 and R6, but still the autofocus in the camera is great. But also in terms of low light, the camera or the autofocus did struggle a bit for me. That's something that I didn't experience with my EOS R6. So if you encounter a lot of low light, then you're gonna might be using the manual focus. So as we are already talking about low light, we have here a super 35 millimeter sensor, so it's like a 1.5x crop compared to full frame. And yeah, I think for a super 35 millimeter, the ISO performance of the camera is really rock solid. So we can use it up to ISO 6400. You can go even one step further, but then I would really recommend you to use like something like noise reduction. But anyway, I think this is a really solid result. So now let's talk about the most important thing, and that is obviously the image quality. And I think the image of the C70 speaks for itself. It's really great, it's detailed, even if we are talking about 4K 60, 4K 24 frames whatsoever. The image quality that you get out of the camera is really, really great, and I think one of the best image qualities out there. If we are talking about 4K image, and also like the dynamic range on the camera is really way above its price point, I think. So it's better than my Blackmagic Pocket, which already has a really decent dynamic range. It's also better than the Z cams. So therefore that was really the most important thing for me when I tested it against my RED Komodo. If you want to see the full test, please watch this video as well. I will link it for you. But in general, the dynamic range of the camera is really, really impressive. Also highlights, the camera handles it really well. I think the Komodo is still a little bit better when it comes to highlight, but what the camera is really great for the C70 is the shadows. So you can really recover the shadows without getting noise and all that stuff in the image, so, or the image breaks apart. So I was really impressed how much detail we still have in the shadows. So if you find yourself in a very different situation, I would rather recommend you to underexpose the camera a little bit and pulling back the shadows in post than making the opposite way. And that kind of already leads me also to slow motion or super slow motion. I think the C70 is the best camera that I've ever tested ever, which does 4K 120. I've already tested some other cameras that did that, but especially the C70 was the clear winner for me out of all of them, better than the Canon R5, Zcam E2 F6. The 4K image in 120, what you get out of this camera is just really outstanding. I can't stress this enough. We have super lot of detail in there. We don't have that much noise, and it's a one-to-one pixel readouts, no line skipping, pixel binning, what we get in the R5. So really great high quality, and also the 4K 60 is really great on the camera. So no complaints about that, and you get the full dynamic range. And also we have the 2K 180 frames per second, which is also really solid. We have a crop there, yes, but I think the image is still really usable and looks great. So I think that's really great. The only thing which we have to talk about a little bit is like high frame rates and autofocus. So when we are using 4K 120, then we lose the track function on the autofocus. We can still move the touch around with our finger on the screen and tap to focus, and the camera will focus on it, no problem at all. But if you are planning on shooting in 4K 120 and you want to track a super fast runner or whatsoever, then that doesn't work. So, and also when we're talking about 2K 180 frames, you don't get autofocus at all. So there you need to manually focus. For me personally, since I don't shoot that much in high frame rate, and always when I do that, I don't need autofocus. So for me, that personally wouldn't be a bummer, but I can imagine that it is for some. But still, I think it's not not a great downside for the image quality that you get in these high frame rates from the C70. Now, before we're gonna wrap up the video, I want to talk about something or some stuff that I didn't like too much about the C70. One of them is the menu. I really like that Canon like changed it a little bit, so we have a part of touch screen. So we have like a little menu where we can find our most used settings like frame rate, picture profile, all the kind of stuff, so that we can configure via touchscreen, and that's really great. But if we're gonna dive deeper into the menu, we have this old normal Canon cinema menu, which we also find on the C200 and C500 and something like that. And I'm personally not a big fan of that menu. It's yes, you can find everything in there, but the question is where you're gonna find it. So I personally think, compared to cameras like the Blackmagic, we already see, or there's cameras out there in the market which has a way more intuitive menu. Also the RED KOMODO is better when it comes to menu. So yeah, just keep that in mind. Not too big of a problem, I would say, but still, just that's my opinion. And also the other thing is the codec that the camera uses. Let me explain a little bit why. So first of all, what codecs we gonna get? So we gonna get an all-I codec. That's the Canon XFAVC 422 10-bit, which is great. You get that up to 30p. When we're recording in higher frame rate, so 60p and even above, then we have a longer format, which is a little bit more compressed, but still 422 10-bit. The longer codec can be a little bit tough to edit. Personally, for me, I have a iMac 2019 maxed out, and yeah, but the XFAVC will edit perfectly, and also the image quality holds up really well. You can really stress this codec in color grading and all that kinds of stuff. So the codecs, even the Longob and also XFAVC, are really rock solid. That thing that I personally don't like is that we don't have ProRes in here. ProRes is kind of the industry standard, if you will. I have that on my Blackmagic Pocket, I have that on my RED KOMODO, and because since I also have a lot of clients like agencies, and sometimes we have like a bigger project where we're gonna do a buyout, so they're gonna get the footage from me, and in 90% of the cases they want to have ProRes. And that's really annoying if you have to transcode, let's say, footage that you shot in the last 3 days or something like that. It's an extra step, and it's gonna take you a lot of time, whereas when you write record it on camera, you can just dump the footage over to your client and you're ready to go. But yeah, also when I'm doing like DP work, when I'm booked from other production companies, they either want RAW from me, and or they want to, in most of the cases, they want to have ProRes. So yeah, that's like kind of a bummer. Then we are also talking now a little bit of RAW. The camera doesn't record in RAW and it won't record via HDMI in RAW. So I'm personally, that's not a concern for me, because I personally don't like the Canon RAW. And we have that in the C300 Mark III, which is double the price, so I understand why Canon didn't do that. But anyway, the Canon RAW isn't that great, because we don't get the configuration and all the kinds of options that we have like in R3D or in Blackmagic RAW. So yeah, and therefore I personally not too concerned about that. So now let's come to the conclusion and find out if the camera is a great fit for you or not. So I personally think the camera is really meant for run and gun style scenarios, and also if you're kind of a one-man band. So if you're doing a lot of events and fast-paced stuff, you can use the camera and it will make you really happy, because the image quality that you get out of this camera is outstanding and it's way above its price point. So therefore, I think the camera is a really great deal. And also, yeah, low light, audio, you basically have everything built in there, which is really great. If you're more working for clients, bigger productions where they want to have ProRes from you or RAW codec or whatsoever, and you want the best image quality possible, even though the image quality of this camera is great, I think, especially for the price point, which I compared it also to the RED KOMODO, the KOMODO is still a little bit better when it comes to that, I would say. But it's a little bit, we are talking about like slightly better, not a huge difference there. So therefore, I think for everybody who wants to use the C70, I think the camera won't disappoint you at all. The camera is really great, and for me personally, one of the best cameras that Canon ever made. So, and also the price of the camera is really great, because we get the sensor of the C300, which is more double than the price. So I think that shouldn't be a bummer. So if you have any further questions, please feel free to contact me or just write a comment. You know how the game works. And if you really like this video, please gonna help me out. Subscribe to my channel, like it, share to all your fellow filmmakers. And I'm gonna see you in my very next video. Cheers.